Okay, team, welcome in everyone. Okay, so this is our community update. It's just basically updating you on everything that's going on our Discord. If you haven't noticed, Discord actually had a big patch earlier, and now we don't have numbers, right? Now it's just D1 OPZ. And also, I don't like how it has this, right? This is kind of weird. But it'll only have this if you're on streamer mode, by the way. So when you see people like this, that means they're on streamer mode, which I don't like. I wish I could just see everyone's name, including myself. I think they should take this off. Yeah. Okay, and let's see what else is going on. So for those of you that are not on our Discord and would like to pop in. The first thing that you will see is the rules section, the welcome section. Click the little shield right there below, and then that'll give you access to everything in our Discord, including the rules section. So basically you won't see a lot of this stuff here. So once you do accept the rules and click the shield, you'll see the rules, and mark any role that pertains to you, whether you're from Africa, Asia, the Caribbean, Central America, Europe, North America, South America, right? Click whatever role pertains to you, and then whether you're a Taurus, Gemini, Aries, right? Shout out to my Geminis, it's Gemini season right now. All that stuff. And if you like Pokemon Unite, click Pokemon Unite. That way you can register for our Unite squads, right? So you would go in here, register your Unite ID, which would be right here. Oh, that's not it. Oh wait, that's the Pokemon world. My bad. So you would register your Unite ID, and see like how Noah did it. He put up his ranked screen, and it lets me know that he's a master 1600, right? And yeah, and this lets me know that this is his ID card, right? It says Noah, and it all matches up. Luna already took care of it, but he gets a badge that says 1600 plus, right? So now he can separate himself amongst everyone and then be in this little special section with only two people, security and Noah, at 1600. Yeah. We do try to keep it very PG in our Discord. We try to keep it clean. Be courteous to others, right? For the rules, the number one thing in the rules is respect. Just be respectful, be courteous of others, and yeah, don't put like crazy stuff, right? Especially like not safe for work stuff. Yeah. So yeah, right? If you guys like what we're doing here and enjoy our streams, you can support us by checking out our other social media, tipping, right? Also, that way we're here streaming a lot more than just 3 days a week. And let's see, if you have any help on Discord help is right here. If you have any ideas, that's another place for you to go in and let us know what you're thinking, right? Anything that you need help, whether it's for Streamwise or Discord, you just don't know how something works, we'll help you out right there. Noah has volunteered actually to help everyone. all right, let's go. So for the updates, I do wanna, I'll go over the updates in a little bit. But the main key things about the updates this week is that Tuesday we watch some anime. We've been watching Naruto. It's almost done. So we're about to head over to Naruto Shippuden very soon in the next couple weeks. Lavender actually shows Pokemon Journeys on Fridays at 10 p.m. Pacific time, or Saturday at 1 a.m. Eastern time. So they're always hosting it on Discord on Friday, so keep an eye out for that, for those of you that are new. And for those of you that haven't done so, please vote for your favorite games on live polls, right? Currently the main games, we'll go over that one in a little bit. Yeah, let's see what's going on in general. Luna provides us with so much information. If you're lost and don't know, you have no idea what's going on, Luna will catch you up on the Discord, right? This is for a lot of you that are new and that are just coming into our community. This is like a perfect summary of literally what's going on. Luna will catch you up on everything, right? So it's pretty cool. Yeah, what's up, fun girl lover? All right, and so let's check out the random section. It seems like we've been playing the Legend of Zelda, right? So then Pablo has been posting a lot of Legend of Zelda.
I need to reach my friend.
Oh. Hey, this is our song. For those of you that have played The Legend of Zelda, you know what this is. You can literally stick a rocket pack on one of the Koroks, right? And then they get sent flying. Yeah. Teehees. Here's a random RL pictures. Oh my gosh. Again, Pablo. You know, you guys should put stuff up. This is Pablo's channel. Hold on. So basically, I think this is Sam's Club, right, Pablo? Yeah, this is definitely Sam's Club. These right here, the croissants are so good. These things are so good. Yeah. Oh, this is Costco? No way. Yeah, in Sam's Club, they have these two guys, so I don't mean to start a war between Sam's Club and Costco. I like them both, right? So, Millie, aka Beauty Mark Babe, aka Ember on our Discord, they're super excited for the new Elemental movie that's coming out, so they're just basically showing us a bunch of books that they were able to get of the same book. Oh, Battle Together, Exploring the Element City. Oh, okay, never mind. It's different kind of books. Okay, just kidding. Some coconut water from Pablo. With pulp. That looks nice. Yeah, see? That movie's the hype. It's coming out on the 16th. For those of you that want to come watch it. And then some pets. Let's check out the pets. So, I can't even see their name anymore. For some reason. Yeah, guys. I don't like this new update. I really don't like this new update. Please don't spoil the movie. Yeah, trust me, I haven't watched it. It hasn't even come out yet. But I will maybe spoil it when I get back. I'm gonna probably go watch it on Saturday. I think that's the plan. But guys, look at this kitty, how cute this is. This cat is something. Low-key, that cat has a piece of my heart. Yeah. And this is their new baby. This is Leslie, aka Scum Mom. You probably have seen Leslie, right? So this cat's name is Chorizo. And it's super cute. Justino! Huskies are so nice, but they do shed a ton, right? Yeah, this is Lavender's puppy. Oh, it looks so cute. Wait, who? This is Alex's cat. Alex has two cats. Lavender, not gonna lie, these dogs usually look super sad. I don't know how you made it look so calm. I'm sorry, but I'm being honest. Yeah, you're a great owner. By the way, a Lavender's a vet. Yeah, not my puppy, but that's Pablo. Wait, Pablo's? No way. Wait, did I get it wrong? No, it's just Lavender. Come on. All right, let's see. And Zodiac has been doing these little projects. This is one of them. Hold on. So basically, they get Funko Pops. And what they do, I don't know if it's glue or what they're doing, but they are putting some glitter on it. This one turned out pretty good. I think they just got to scrape out a little bit of the eye, right? Just to make it look nice, circular, and clean. And it'll actually look pretty good. Not bad, right? So here they are messing around with the Flareon. Oh, no, the dog's name is Pablo. Oh, okay, never mind. Yeah. As you can tell, Millie is super excited for the new movie that's going on. This is actually pretty funny. Freezing Fire put this up. Guys really live in apartments like this and don't see any issue. This is probably going to be me when I do get my apartment. And like I said, I plan on moving on December. So depending on how everything is, how everything's going, there's going to be a lot of change here around that point. Possible, right? But I have to get going in December, and this is literally how my setup is gonna be. I'm gonna picture perfect, copy and paste. I was roaming at David's. No, Alright, let's see. Early bird, night owl, true, Drassi all day, then panicking about your choice, your live choices at night cat. What? Alright, let's go. That was pretty cool though. Guys, post your music. I listen to your songs while I edit, right? I think the new movie is kind of like Avatar, The Last Airbender. Yeah? Kind of. Have you guys seen the other Avatar, like the Blue People Avatar? So basically, the first one was the first movie. The first one was air, right? The second one was water. Apparently, the third one's going to be about fire. And then the last one, the fourth one, it should be Earth. But for the Earth one, they're going to return to planet Earth to see how it looks. So this is the Blue People movie. So I'm pretty excited for what the director is doing. It sounds so cool. And by the way, the third movie, installation's already done, completed, and filmed. Now they're working on the CGI effects. Don't spoil the movie. I'm not spoiling the movie. It's just things that are already out. All right. I haven't watched it yet. No, yeah. You still have to watch it. Pachirisu, you still gotta watch it. All right. Yeah. But it's just the concept. Oh man, this is some good stuff. Boba time. Ooh, the pictures. Okay, here we go. I went to go get some boba. This is my mom right here, right? My mom, my brother, myself. We went to go try some pistachio boba. We said no more boba. We are not gonna have boba anymore in our drinks, but we are gonna get the drinks, but not the boba part, because we feel so heavy, right? And I don't know, boba just makes us feel chunky. Yeah, so we're gonna stop that. Millie says, cook the greatest dinner you can create in this household. Yeah, is that garlic salt? Did he like it? I did like it, but it was just too much boba and it felt heavy. Yeah, so no more boba balls for me for a while. Actually, I'm gonna try the mango ones, because there's different bobas, right? But I think the other ones, I think you're able to chew them and then they turn into liquid, no? I'm gonna try those. Yeah. I would eat this, Millie. Rock salted salmon. Usually eat some with hot rice. Ooh, that's actually really good. I don't know if you have ever been to some Vietnamese places. This kind of salmon is actually really good. Jelly filled? Oh, are they jelly filled? Because again, I haven't tried them. I usually get the honey bobas. Oh, this is Pablo's Burger. Sometimes you need a boja from a diner. Wait, what's a boja? What does that mean? But I don't know, but that avocado is tantalizing. And that cheese. Here we go. Some El Pollo Loco. Have you guys gone to El Pollo Loco lately? What do you guys rate it? Let's see some health and fitness stuff. A little funny way of saying a burger. Ah, okay. I should have known. So if you guys check the health and fitness channel, Luna does post some pretty awesome quotes, right? So best thing I ever did was believe in me, right? These are, you might see something that might catch your eye and resonate with you at the moment, but there's always great stuff here. I need to go back and read some of those. Right, we did post this. It's from the new Five Nights at Freddy movie trailer that I saw in theaters. That's when I went to go watch Fast and Furious, the new one that just came out. I was just really surprised that they were actually making a Five Nights at Freddy movie. And as you can tell, I just barely find that out. And some of you already knew. Okay. Oh, yeah. So I recently discovered... this is in our astronomy section. I recently discovered that we are living in two galaxies. Like, well, one galaxy, the main one. But there's two galaxies within our galaxy, right? So, there was this dwarf galaxy. It was called the Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy. Look it up. This is some real stuff, right? So basically, it was out there. It collided with us, right? And then it's just been spinning around us, leaving its trails everywhere, right? So currently, it's like this. It's really cool. Look it up. Look it up. Yeah, look up Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy. So it's literally combining with our Milky Way galaxy, which is pretty cool. Yeah, look it up. Look it up. 100%. Really cool, huh? Yeah, so I don't know. People are saying that there's a lot of talk over this, and you know, it's we really don't know what happens, right? But some people say like that's how one of the other planets is spinning the other way, right? Some people say it doesn't belong in our solar system. Some people say maybe that's why we have like an anomaly planet that's out there that hasn't been discovered. Maybe it's because of all this. Who knows, right? Does that mean we're all gonna die? No. I don't know. It's just this has already been happening. This was 8 billion years ago, right? That's when it was separated from us. And then this was 5.7 billion years ago when it first passed us, right? 3 billion years ago. 1.9 billion years ago, second Sagittarius passage. So it already passed by us once, right? Twice. And then 1 billion years ago, it passed by us again. And then currently, so it's currently right here. So it's like halfway to making its next full passage, right? I heard the Andromeda one is gonna collide as well. Yeah, so there's Andromeda too that's supposed to collide with us as well. By the way, the update already is happening right now in Pokemon Unite for those of you that are excited for the update. Gonna just get that going in the background, right? Yeah, so the Andromeda galaxy, but that's a long time from now. This right here, the Sagittarius passage, is actually it's here. So yeah, so again, this is the current situation. Look it up. Yeah, do your own research, right? I just don't want to say anything. Yeah, right, everyone needs to make their mind up about all this stuff, but it's all real science. See, put up our birth flowers. So again, we have astronomy and we do have astrology section, so for those of you that are interested in astrology, this is a cool page for you to check out, right? So birth flowers. So carnation is a January, primrose February. I hope I said that right for January. I'm sorry. Daffodil March, daisy April, lily of the valley May, rose June, larkspur July, the poppy August, ester September, marigold October, and chrysanthemum, I don't know, I think so, that's November, and narcissus. Wait, what? December? Is that the name of it? Narcissus? I don't even know, guys. Don't quote me on that. I'm running away. All right, let's go. Let's see the gaming news. Okay, you guys haven't posted too much on the gaming news. All right, that's good stuff. Alex, this is a random gaming chat, so if we don't have a channel for a certain game, you guys can just type in the gaming chat and then we can check out some of the stuff that you've been up to, right? So that's pretty cool. I know Zelda has been popping off lately, and let's see what we have here, right? So this is the latest one. I haven't seen this. At Dallas Comic Con, and thought you guys would love this as much as I did. Gosh, I feel so bad for this character in The Legend of Zelda, right? It's basically, he has to hold that every single time. Chrysanthemum. Yeah, that's a lot. Luna. All right, and again, the Pokemon stuff, I don't know if you guys did this, but Jal, Carlos, and a couple of us, we did the community today. right? So there was a community day this Saturday, and this was basically the catches I got, right? Or shinies, not all the catches, but I ended up getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 shinies. None of them were that good. We also did try to trade some stuff with Carlos, because Carlos is going to be, by the way, shout out to Carlos. Carlos is going to be competing in the Pokemon Go. I guess tournament. I don't know. It's a big competition, kind of like how Unite has its competition, right? Championship series. So it's like the Pokemon Go championship series. So I wanted to support Carlos, but I can't because he's so far away. So if anyone figures out how I'm able to transfer Pokemon to Carlos, please let me know. I know when the game first started, Pokemon Go, when it first started, I was able to transfer things to people from all over the world. But I guess now you really can't, right? This was Jal's Haxorus. That's a pretty good one. He powered it up. I'm pretty sure you powered it up, right, Jal? Because that's insane. Yeah. And then Jal updated us on more Pokemon Go stuff. On July 9th, 2 p.m. to 5 p.m., like always, there's going to be Squirtles. And if you missed out on the last Squirtle event, these Squirtles, you get a chance of one of these two, or I mean some of them, to have glasses. So if you're trying to get your glasses, your Squirtles with glasses, July 9th, it's a must. I want them, so I'm for sure gonna do that, right? These, and then not only those glasses, but it has the other Squirtle with the pointy glasses. I think that one's a little bit more rare because it's like the little leader. I don't know, my Spanish is coming out right now.
This is gonna be a piece of cake.
Here's the first question. Identify this Pokemon.
This is gonna be a breeze for me. It's a Voltorb.
Ah, how simple. It's a Pokeball, without a doubt.
Obviously, it's an Electrode.
And the answer is a Jigglypuff seen from above. Next question. What Pokemon displays this pattern?
I've never seen that.
It must be an Omanyte shell.
It's an Arbok when it's all coiled up.
Hey, it's a Poliwhirl.
The correct answer? Poliwag. As any master would know, when Poliwag evolves into Poliwhirl, the swirl on its stomach reverses direction.
Wow.
It's hard.
And it's getting harder by the minute.
Oh, God.
Question 15. What Pokemon does this tail belong to?
It's either Charizard, Charmeleon, or Charizard.
Ponyta.
Yeah, it's gotta be Charmander.
The answer is Ponyta.
No, it can't be.
Damn. I would fail some of these for sure. Holy.
Vika!
Holy.
Too scary.
Vika, Vika. Vika.
That's so cute. I like that. All right. Yeah, but that's all the information I got for you guys from there. And for those of you that are interested in joining or challenging our Pokemon League, we do have a Pokemon League. By the way, register here, right? But I do want to congratulate SweetScent for becoming our Poison type gym leader. 8th gym leader. So they're our newest member of our Pokemon League, right? So they were able to go through Justin, Flame Fist, Venom, myself, and Deer, right? So they kick butt, and if you want to come in and kick butt yourselves, you can. There's still gym opening, so do your best. We are looking still to fill this out, this roster out. But again, it's SweetScent, 8th gym leader, Justin, Flame Fist, Venom, myself, Elite Four members, and our champion is Jir. So just register and you'll be all good. That'll be on Discord. Again, for Pokemon Unite, because we're playing it right now, all you gotta do is register here, and it's really easy. Once again, just like how Noah did it, go to the rank section, take a screenshot, or just take a picture from your phone, and put it up and take a another picture of just your trainer info, and then that's all you need, and we will put you where you need to be, depending on what elo you're at and your ranking, right? So master and then your elo will put you here on 1600. Yeah, right. So yeah, Luna pinned up everything, so basically just follow those directions, you'll be fine. And again, you can always ask for help, right? All right, team. And then the last thing we do want to do is we want to check the new games that are coming out, but let's dive deep a little bit more on the live polls. The game with the most votes, please, if you haven't done so and you're a Discord server booster or a Twitch sub, right, come here and vote for your favorite game. That way I can stream your game here on Twitch, like Five Nights at Freddy's. We're streaming it, right? You guys voted for it, we're streaming it, right? Super Smash Bros, man, it's gone through its ups and downs, but there's been a lot more downs than ups, but we're keeping it there, right? So that's second right now, and third is The Legend of Zelda Tears of a Kingdom. It's not doing so hot like it was, but at some point it was. Let's see. And the upcoming game is the cooking streams. You guys really want me to cook, and we'll get some cooking done. We'll do it. Let's go. I'm ready. And then another game that's really popping off right now is the food critic stream. So we can go out to other restaurants and we can see what you guys want me to order from those restaurants. Yeah, that would be very exciting. I'll take you guys out, basically. And we'll eat some food there. That'd be pretty cool. But I don't know if you guys have checked the brand new games that we do have out or that are coming out. Aliens Darkest Descent, Final Fantasy, The Story of Seasons, Forever Skies, and Pegasus. So let's check this out. Right? Let's check these games out. Do do do. Okay, we're gonna start out with Pegasus. These are the games I have high hopes for in the second half of June, right? Can't eat food through the screen. Oh, I know you can't eat food through the screen, but it's literally me taking you out. Come on. All right, the Pegasus Expedition. So this is a game I'm interested about.
There is never enough time to save our home, our world, our future. Race against the unstoppable tide. Run headfirst into the unknown and hear the clock slowly ticking away.
So basically, it looks like you control your fleet in outer space, right? And it looks like you're taking over a whole solar system. That's the sun, and this is your fleet, right? And the whole point is to command the entire solar system. It feels like.
To send our fleets, our agents, our colonists to tame this cold, hostile alien.
Those are the factions. And basically it breaks everything down. Oh gosh, it's a little bit loud. Hold on.
The day of reckoning is nigh. Will you make it in time?
Yeah, those are the factions. But I think this game is really cool. I like strategic games like that, and these are my type of games. I would be extremely down to play this game, and it comes out on the 20th. Yeah. Okay, and then this is this other game. I don't know if you guys have played Subnautica, but this game is called Forever Skies. And it's basically like Subnautica. Yeah, but this is literally like Subnautica, all right? So you build your ship, It's gonna be an airship. The ocean is my biggest fear. No worries, this is not an ocean. It looks like you're kinda in a city. I guess you are kind of in the ocean. It looks like you're in the ocean right there, right? Just because of bubbles? Yeah, I don't know. I know quite a bit of you. 8 Subnautica, right? So that's why I put it up in the polls. Because I thought some of you would be interested in it. And it looks like a fun exploration game, so I would be pretty down to explore. Yeah, Forever Skies, Return to Earth. So apparently that's Earth now, in Subnautica. Or technically, right? Okay, and then this game, it's a cute game. At one point in time, Animal Crossing. Whoa, this game, this thing broke. Jeez. Okay. All right. Let's see. Hello? Yeah. It's broken, guys. Okay. Okay, at some point in time, Animal Crossing was,
an unforgettable tale.
Was one of the top games here on our Twitch channel, right? It was doing amazing. It was literally the game. So Sword of the Seasons is really close to that, but it seems like a very cute game to play, so.
Family and farming.
I had to put it up here.
Story of Seasons, a wonderful life. Welcome to Forgotten Valley, a tranquil community far from the city.
I haven't played a farming simulator in so long.
A fertile land to grow crops and care for animals. A vibrant valley with mystical woodland, ancient ruins, and abundant gifts from nature. A community of friendly faces to help you find your feet.
And the cool part is that... you basically grow older as
life
the seasons go.
The people you meet.
It looks like Animal Crossing, right? With,
that you start a family with.
You can literally have a baby in that game.
It's full of happy moments. And some sad ones, too. Guide your child as they forge their own path.
Kind of crazy.
Spend time with family. Grow together.
Right? And then you actually get old. Say farewell to your child. Yeah.
Make memories that last.
Damn,
life.
Dude. Did he see the grave? Oh my god.
Welcome back to a beloved farming classic.
I'd be down for this game.
Story of Seasons, a wonderful life.
Yeah. And it's actually on PS5, Xbox, Steam, Switch, and like everything, right? Pretty cool. Alright, this game, a lot of you have been talking about it. Here we go. What the? Okay, here we go. Final Fantasy.
The Blind March is on. These people live with a knife to their throat.
You have to believe us! We'd help you if we could!
But you're helping us already. We never asked to be saved. Did you think we'd thank you? They'll never forgive us. We're all marked now.
Every time you show your faces, it is we who suffer.
The monsters look so good.
You better hope so.
Crystals take more than they give.
You mean to tell me that the mother crystals are the reason the world is dying?
Jeez.
If they won't give us a say, we'll decide our fates another way. Are you with me?
You will pay for what you've done!
Why aren't you dead? You
Holy.
Got branded!
Tell me true. Do you believe what I'm about to do is wrong?
I was forced to kill. You do it by choice.
This is not the trailer I've seen.
They believe in the power of the dominant.
You can't blame a man for wanting to bring an end to all this, can you?
Ever led astray by your blind resolve.
And thus is the light of hope severed. We don't need your salvation. We'll save ourselves, and we'll do it on our own terms.
Come to me, Ifrit!
Holy.
Who are we? What are
the dominants? It's basically a movie.
We are but mighty acts of God.
Enough of this! I use my talents to my advantage, and you would tell me there is shame in that?
You get to use the monsters.
I would be the king of the world.
Okay, that thing is
darkness
huge.
Darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself.
I don't want to be a monster, Clive.
I have to stop him. I have to save them.
I made a promise to my friends, and it is they who will give me the strength to end your reign. Your efforts will avail us naught.
Yeah, that looks so beautiful.
We fight. We survive. We endure. We don't need a reason.
Five!
And yeah, game is coming out very, very soon. June 22nd. So there we go. And then for the last one, Aliens. This is the fifth one. Let's see it. Yeah, that
Hello,
trailer was epic.
And welcome to this exclusive first look at Aliens Dark Descent.
I kind of like the strategy behind
this
game. In this
short preview, we reveal what kind of experience awaits you.
I don't know if you guys are into tactical shootings. Like tactical games.
Dark Descent is a real-time, squad-based tactical action game.
This is really pushing the limits of gaming.
You are the commander. Marines are your weapon. You are tasked with investigating a sinister uprising that caused a vicious xenomorph outbreak on the moon. Your squad is controlled fluidly and intuitively as one unit, where any command you issue is automatically dispatched to the Marines best equipped for the task. Whether you're using mouse and keyboard or
you'd
a controller,
controlling
we want you to
all,
be fully immersed
them.
In the world
like the
and
whole
the iconic
squad.
Aliens experience.
You know what to do.
Lead strategically. Enter combat without breaking stride, slowing down time at the touch of a button, just enough to distribute tactical orders with military precision. Tread carefully, though, because death is permanent in Dark Descent, and losing a Marine in combat is irreversible.
Yeah, so if you lose,
forge unique
one of
paths
your people, they're gone.
Explore large open levels to complete story missions and side objectives.
Come out friendly like, yeah? Don't shoot!
Level up your loyal Marines with special abilities, perks, and gear, and customize the squad composition to optimize each run. At Tyndalos, we're extremely excited to bring this game to all fans of the legendary Aliens license and to all the real-time action strategy fans.
Yeah. I think that's super cool. Like the real-time strategy, that's epic, and that's on June 20th as well. So as you can tell, all these games are from the second half of June. And that'll be it for our community update. I want to update all of you on all these games. The brand new games that are coming up for you all to vote. So join our Discord and vote. Okay? All right. Let's go. Let's check out this Pokemon Unite.